You, as a football manager, wish to win all the trophies that are available in your safe. And to do so, you need to have the best players. Now, the best players can come in the form of the most expensive ones, or in the form of wonderkids on their path to becoming stars. In today's video, we are going to take a look at the latter category, listing some of the best Asian wonderkids in the game, who are on their way to become high-profile players. We start in Thailand with Nataut Suksam. He has played so far for Bangkok United at various levels and for FC Tokyo Under 23. He has just started to break through the Bangkok United squad and scored 12 goals in 29 games last season, scoring in 41% of the games he has played. However, one downside for Nataut would be that he has not played outside of Thailand, so he's untested in other leagues. So, buying him for your club would present itself a risk. If you wish to be as close to zero as possible on the risk rate scale, you could add him to your shortlist and wait for his contract to expire to take him on a free transfer. But if you wish to move faster, Bangkok United would accept 250k euros, future fees included. Just beware that if you manage in England, he may struggle with his work permit at the beginning of the game. Now, in terms of why you should pay attention to him, let's start by focusing on his position and role. With his stature, he can be played as both a striker or a winger, depending on your preferences. He can play the ball using his weak foot fairly well, which means that he can serve as an inside wing player very well, or can be used as a striker who should have no problems in finding the back of the net on a regular basis. His finishing and first touch should be a mandatory part of his development moving forward, while his off the ball, flair and anticipation should not be neglected at all. If you choose the path of the winger, I believe it is mandatory to develop his dribbling, technique, pace and agility. Without these attributes fairly high, I cannot envisage him being a good winger. His personality is good, so he will focus on his work during your save. One other Thai wonderkid is Supanat Muntha, so you might want to keep an eye on him as well. Okay, next! From Thailand, we move to Israel, but as a club to Shakhtar Donetsk. You may know Manor Solomon from past FM editions or from your saves, but in case you did not hear about him until now, hey, glad to help you! Now, Manor is an established international player for Israel, being capped 19 times and even scoring 3 times. Being bought for 6 million euros, Shakhtar would certainly want to receive something on their investment in his development, so Manor will be pricey. I mean, around 60 million euros pricey. But not only because he holds return on investment value, but just look at his stats, and he's still a 21 years old player. Buying him for 60 million euros today can become selling him for 150 million euros in the future. High dribbling, first touch and technique ensures he can dribble his way past opponents with relative ease. His mental attributes like composure or decisions start high in my save and most likely in most saves, while his physicals are on the right track. He's not a speedster or a very agile player, talking about winger qualities, but he doesn't need to be one if you are going to use him as an inverted winger or inside forward. He's a versatile player, but I would not fare too far from the winger position. If the price tag puts you off, just think that you are buying a player who has the necessary skill set, international experience, and potential to become a star in most of the top 5 European leagues. We couldn't talk about Asian wonderkids and not have Japan listed, or South Korea for that matter, but more on that later. Reo Hatate has just been bought by Celtic from Japan, but this does not mean that he's not a player you shouldn't monitor. He has plenty of experience playing in Japan, and you'll have at least 6 months until he becomes available for transfer again to monitor and see how well he plays in Europe. As current ability goes, he has very good starting first touch and passing abilities, and if you wish to play him as a box-to-box midfielder, he has the tackling, teamwork and stamina to do so. Of course, his tackling can and should be improved further, alongside his positioning, decisions, composure and anticipation, but he does possess fairly good technical attributes, which will go up as he's playing games. His role is going to be very important in any tactic due to the position he's good at. That is why I would carefully ponder his development if I were to buy him. What I would also do, in order to make sure I tick all the boxes, would be subscribing to the channel. You should do it too. And while you are doing that, enabling the bell notifications ensures that you are not going to miss any video. We get back to an Israeli player, but this time to one who is still playing in Israel. Eilon is a 22-year-old youth international who has just begun to establish himself in the first team of Maccabi Tel Aviv. Now, there is a red flag that I should tell you about, which is that Eilon does not have any good composure, decisions or concentration, at least in my save. I know these are important attributes for a striker, but if you are to go all in and focus on his finishing abilities, that could prove a good decision in the future. He can become a goal machine even without having the best mental attributes for the role. In this case, I think that the best role for him is pressing forward, as you would want him to capitalize on the goal chance as much as possible during a match. For securing his services, Maccabi Tel Aviv accepts 1.5 million euros plus a future fee. Again, be warned, managers in the UK, Eilon may not receive a work permit right from the off. I know that he's a mixed pack, and maybe you even wonder why I present him in the list, but Eilon is still 22 years old, so plenty of room for improvement, and if you play your cards right, you can make him a pure striker in your team. Ritsu is the second Japanese player on our list, but with very good abilities for his age, being able to use his both feet well, and having high leagues experience plus the international one, Ritsu could not have missed our list. He has been playing in Holland and Germany for quite some time now, and I believe he's at the point in his career where he's ready to make the step towards a big club. He's versatile, as he could play as both an attacking midfielder or a winger, but I would use him as an attacking midfielder. Very high first touch, technique and vision help him possess the ball and read the game well, while his agility plus his diminutive stature help him brush off opposing defenders quite easily. His passing attribute would need a bit of work in order to complete his passer abilities, while his anticipation and acceleration would need to be developed further, as he would need to spot and distribute a pass quite fast. To complement his attributes, I would ask him to train the traits of dictates tempo and plays 1-2s in order to capitalize on his very good reading of the game and enhance the speed of his distribution. Of course, you could develop him as you wish in your save, but Ritsu is a player right at the peak of his growth, and I will make everything possible to ensure my club will be the one benefiting from his full development. Woo Young-chung is the South Korean player I was telling you about earlier, and I think you should pay attention and monitor him closely. He can play as an inverted winger or inside forward on both flanks, and can use his weak foot very well. He's a bit of an aggressive player, but has great pace, off the ball and flair, which make him a pretty fast dribbler. He has a firm foothold in the German game, and Freiburg will not let him go easily, but they will let him go for the right price, and that right price is about 17.5 million euros. If I were to buy him, I would focus his development on his dribbling, first touch and technique. This would enhance his dribbling ability, and in order to take advantage of his skills, I would go for the traits of places shots and plays 1-2s, as it will make him a more clinical finisher. In my save, Woo Young-chung becomes a most wanted player by Premier League clubs and has started to make his appearance on the international stage, so if I were you, I would try to make sure I buy him as early as possible. I know that scouting and developing wonder kids is one of the favorite football manager related activities, thus, make sure to watch this video here listing the best European wonder kids. I'm Alex and I thank you for watching today's video. As always, dear audience, stay safe, relax and have fun.